If you've spent some time watching large ships in a harbor, you will have noticed smaller tugboats helping them to move in tight spaces. The general tugboat is a small boat with incredibly powerful engines. Their power-to-weight ratio can be more than 9-to-1. However, the tugs we're going to look at in this video are absolutely massive and about 4 times more powerful than your average tug. These tugs are the biggest in the world. They're called Anchor Handling Tug Supply Vessels, or AHTS for short, and their name describes their multi-purpose role. These ships are used to set anchors for oil rigs, to tow the mobile drilling rigs into position and secure them in place, and for towing and moving large ships as well. The tugs are fitted with huge engines and powerful cranes. The pulling power of these tugs is measured in tons using a bollard pull test. A bollard pull test measures the pulling power of a tug. This is done by securing the tug via a cable to a bollard on shore. The tug powers up its engines, and the force or tension on the cable is measured. The more powerful the tug, the higher the bollard pull value is in tons. The tug you see in this bollard pull test is the ALP Striker. Whilst this is a massive ship with a bollard pull of 312 tons, it's not quite enough to make our top 10 list. In fact, it would sit at number 13 on a list of the world's most powerful anchor handling tugs. Number 10 is the Scandi Iguasa. She's a new generation, high-powered, anchor handling tug supply ship designed for field installation projects. The ship was constructed in 2012 and is owned by DOFASA, a Norwegian shipping company. She sails under the Brazilian flag, and her home port is Rio de Janeiro. The Scandi Iguasa has a length of 95 meters and is 25 meters wide with a 7.8 meter draft. She's powered by 7 engines that produce 22,000 horsepower. And her bollard pull test resulted in 340 tons. Very impressive. And that's just number 10 on our list. The next 3 tugs on our list are also owned by the Norwegian shipping company DOF. Number 9 is the Scandi Skansen, with a bollard pull of 349 tons. Number 8 is the Scandi Vega, with a bollard pull of 350 tons. And number 7 is the Scandi Hercules, which just beats the Vega, with a bollard pull of 354 tons. The Hercules has a length of 109 meters, and its 10 main engines put out a whopping 25,000 horsepower. Positions 6 and 5 are taken up by 2 K-line ships, namely the Sandefjord and the Saltfjord. K-Line Offshore is a subsidiary of Kawasaki Kaizen Keisha Limited. Both these ships were constructed in 2011 and are used in underwater seabed operations and deep water trenching work. Both ships have accommodation for 70 people in 45 cabins. The Lewek Fulmar takes position number 4. Sailing under the flag of Panama, this anchor handler was constructed by Dry Docks World Singapore in 2011. This ship not only services offshore oil platforms, but it's also capable of undertaking subsea construction works and repair, maintenance and safety duties. It is propelled by Mach 16 VM32C powerful engines with a total power of 21,455 kilowatts, allowing a bollard pull of 405 tons. The Fulmar is 93 meters long, and it has 3 decks and 2 cranes, with a lifting capacity of 20 tons. Lewek Fulmar can easily accommodate 85 people, and has a maximum sailing speed of 80 knots or 33 kilometers per hour. It seems like 2011 was a popular year to make anchor handling tugs, because here's another one from that year. It's the Boka Falcon, and it's number 3 on our list. It is operated by the Boskalis Westminster, a dredging company and marine services provider based in Hampshire, UK. The Boka Falcon is used in ocean transportation oil drilling projects, and subsea installation works of offshore production platforms and wind farms. She sails under the Belgium flag. The ship's dimensions are 93.4 meters long, 22 meters wide, and an 8.8 meters draft. An interesting fact about this tug is that in 2020, the Boker Falcon laid the anchors and chains for anchoring the floating wind turbines in Scotland at an underwater depth of 80 meters. What's her bollard pull? 403 tons. Okay. Well, that actually means the Lewek Fulmar should take position 3 with its bollard pull of 405 tons. Number 2 is the Far Samson. The Far Samson is currently the second most powerful offshore vessel in the world. She was constructed in 2009 in Norway, and an interesting fact is that she was designed by Rolls-Royce. Speaking of Rolls-Royce, you should check out our video showing the most expensive cars in the world. There's a few Rolls-Royces on that list, and you'll need more than $10 million to buy one. Anyway, back to the Far Samson. With a length of 121 meters, she's way longer than most tugs on this list. Its twin hybrid engine produced 30,500 kilowatts, and it's got a bollard pull rating of 423 tons. Number 1. Island Victory. Well, if you thought 423 tons was impressive, you haven't seen the best yet. Built in Norway in 2020, this powerful vessel is owned by Island Offshore and sails under the Norwegian flag. She's 123 meters long and can accommodate 110 people. This vessel is used for anchor handling, oil well maintenance, and wind turbine installations. Its twin Rolls-Royce engines put out 31,400 kilowatts, and it's the current world record holder, with a bollard pull of 477 tons. Its equipment includes a 250-ton offshore AHTS crane, a 12-ton deck crane, and two rail cranes. It also has two ROVs that can easily reach an underwater depth of 4,000 meters. Well, that's it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. We hope you enjoyed it and learnt a few new things. Check out the rest of the channel for more great content. See you in the next one.